Well, yes, the elephants left us really, James. They decided it was time to carry on their morning movements, and they've headed off in a westerly direction away from the pan. But we came down our termite mound and we were just having a look where they were drinking, and we came across the beautiful frog that's sitting on its rock, absorbing some morning sunshine, much like what we were doing on our termite mound a few minutes ago. And this is a striped grass frog. So there are quite a few of them around, and they're a quite widely spread species. You'll find them from coastal areas all the way up into the low veld and even up onto the high veld as well. So they're pretty much spread throughout South Africa. You can see there's a very brave insect crawling over that frog. Be careful, little insect. You might end up as dinner. Or not breakfast, should I say. We're not anywhere near dinner at this stage. But these guys, what's quite interesting with them is that even though they're in water like this, and this breed, because obviously they'll lay their tadpole, their eggs inside here, and tadpoles will hatch. Funny enough with them, if they feel like there's danger coming, that they'll actually leave water. So they'll, rather than going into the open water and swimming around, you'll find that the frogs will actually start moving away, and they'll jump away from water and into vegetation to hide. And you probably find it's because they're not the best swimmers, and so they would be really sort of heavily preyed upon by fish and varying other water sort of predators. So that's why they'll move away. But it's an interesting sort of tactic. Most other frogs will dive and try and get into sort of the water and into vegetation on the bottom of the particular water source that you're in, but these guys jump out in a way which is quite amazing. So nice to see frogs. It's this time of the year, it shouldn't really be seeing too many of them, as these sort of water poles are drying out. It's tough to actually find them, and they'll also go into a sort of state of estivation that James was talking about earlier, and saying that it's getting cold now, and so a lot of our animals are going to stop this sort of movement that they have and start going into estivation, which is pretty much like hibernation. It's just that it's not activated by cold. Estivation is activated by dry weather and not cold weather. All right, now we're going to carry on our sort of mission towards the northeast and see what else we can find. We've been